One of the biggest challenges facing deep space missions is protecting astronauts against cosmic radiation. Electrically charged particles from the Sun and galaxy, galactic cosmic rays, can damage cells and break the DNA. Exposure to radiation during long-duration interplanetary missions can cause cancer, leukemia, cardiovascular and neurological damage to the astronauts. Passive shields stop radiation thanks to interaction with matter. But meters of materials are needed around a spacecraft to offer enough protection. Active shields deflect charged particles before they hit the astronaut's habitat. The SR2S team is studying how to deflect particles with new, advanced superconducting magnets. For the first time, both technical aspects and systems interactions have been investigated. A charged particle moving in a magnetic field experiences a force and therefore deflects. Earth's magnetosphere shields our planet with a weak but very extended magnetic field. To protect a spacecraft, we need a more compact but very strong magnetic field. Consequently, we must use the technology of superconductivity. A superconductor is a material that, if kept a few degrees above absolute zero, carries electric currents with no resistance. Using superconductors, it is possible to generate very high fields without power dissipation. A very light and stable superconducting cable was designed based on the superconducting compound magnesium diboride, surrounded by titanium and aluminium. The main requirements for a spaceborne superconducting magnet are low weight and high reliability. The field must be confined in order not to affect spacecraft attitude, devices, and astronauts. The choice of the superconductor and magnet design should fulfill these requirements. Many magnetic configurations have been studied to find the best combination concerning radiation effect reduction, magnetic properties, and mass of the system. The best configurations resulted from a set of light, self-supporting toroidal magnets. These magnets are modular. Their field is partially confined within the magnet. Several arrangements are possible based on toroids. The most effective and promising is a new arrangement, nicknamed the pumpkin configuration. The novelty of the arrangement has been supported by a very ambitious design, which involves new cable, extremely high magnetic energy density, and light structural materials never before used in magnet technology. SR2S introduced several important technological achievements, which will have an impact not only in active shielding. However, completing the design and build of an active shield is a long-term project, which goes well beyond the SR2S project. The cryogenic system keeps the magnet at a low temperature, providing very good thermal insulation and removing the heat coming from the sun and human habitat. Space sunshield technology will be used to deflect the heat coming from the sun. The heat load coming from the human habitat will be intercepted by a thermal shield connected to cryocoolers via thermal links of very high conductance, namely pulsating heat pipes, or PHPs. The SR2S team developed the longest cryogenic PHP ever designed to cool down objects some meters distant in space, operating at about 200 degrees Celsius below zero. A new superconducting cable has been developed, made with magnesium diboride in a titanium support matrix. It is lighter than usual superconducting cables and does not need liquid helium. Its characteristics make the cable potentially applicable to other fields, like beamlines for cancer hadron therapy.